Hello, G Mamas. Today I will be talking about choosing baby names and why I chose the name that I chose for my baby and the journey, how controversial the name was, and give you 7 tips on how to narrow down and choose the best name for your baby. So the reason I chose the name of my baby, well, the name to begin with, Dante, D-A-N-T-E. The way it started was beginning of 2017 when I met my husband. After 4 months together, we went to Italy for a week, and he was showing me places that I haven't seen in my previous trip. And one of these places was Florence, which is a beautiful city. Put in your bucket list if you haven't been. And even if you have been to Italy, definitely consider going again and going to places you haven't seen. Anyway, so we went to Florence, and as we were walking around the streets, I just saw a statue of Dante Alighieri. Dante Alighieri was a poet 700 years ago who wrote the Divine Comedy, poetry book describing hell, purgatory, and heaven. I have read that book when I was preparing for my test, getting into university. In Brazil, you finish high school and you have to pass a university entry test where you have to read a few books, and one of them was this book. I probably wouldn't pick it myself, but I had to read it anyway, so I gave it a go. It's about 700 and something pages of very old way of poetry. So even though I read in Portuguese and I'm not a slow reader, it took me a year to finish reading that book. It's a very intense book. Is really difficult old words. It was just so amazing to me to read something that 700 years ago a person was going through personal struggles, which is Dante Alighieri's life, if you're interested, which I was, and he definitely translated what he was feeling through this book. It took him years to finish the book, but he was so creative. The creativity for me was what was more intense, and I was just fascinated by the way he wrote. But I also love the name Dante, which for me is great because it's small, as I said, it's easy to pronounce in the 3 languages that we need. English, Portuguese, and Italian will pronounce similarly. When we were in Florence and I saw that statue and reminded me of everything that I learned in school and the book that I've read and how fascinated I was at the time, and I told my husband, oh my god, if we ever had a boy, the name would be Dante. Definitely, there will be Dante. I love this name so much. And all the Italian friends and family were not very sure about this name if we ever had a boy. Everyone that was Italian, Brazilians love it, Australians love it, but the Italians were like, why Dante? Oh, I'm not sure. But according to my husband, he reckons it's because the name is not very used anymore and it's an old name, and also because apparently, Italians were supposed to read this book when they were 13 to 14 in school, and that was definitely not a book that a teenager would like to read, which I totally understand that point, and that's one of the reasons why they kind of got a grudge against Dante and maybe against his name, which is a bit weird, but it's okay. Some of them maybe didn't like the name because of Dante's hell, which people talk more about Dante's hell than Dante's heaven, which he wrote about hell, but he wrote about heaven too, and it's beautiful. Because some people maybe have not read completely the book or have not studied enough, they probably think that's a negative name because it's connected to creating hell or something like that, but that's That's crazy. Regardless of what people in Italy or everywhere think about the name, I love the name. My husband was happy with the name, and he also thinks the name is strong and give, you know, a personality and identity to the baby. Once I got pregnant, and I thought, okay, could be a boy, could be a girl. So if it's a boy, we'll be Dante. So let's check the name and see if there is a meaning. I found out that the name has a Latin meaning. In fact, the name comes from durante. So durante in Latin means, we shorten to Dante. In Latin, it means durable, lasting, endurance. When I found out that was the meaning of the name, I loved even more, because for me, that's probably one of the most important characteristics you have to have in your personality, in your identity, to survive a constantly changing world like we live now, especially now, as we are rapidly changing constantly, and we have to be endurant, we have to be persistent, we have to be resilient. And that's the name that I thought, wow, that's perfect. It's a short name, it's easy to pronounce, so he doesn't have to teach people a foreign word when he's introducing himself, so he will be able to introduce himself with confidence. So for you, I made a little list, and I'm gonna read here what you can do to choose the baby name if you're not sure yet. Even if you don't want to know the gender of your baby, you still can select the favorite girl name and the favorite boy name during this exercise. So the first thing that I would say for you to ask yourself is, what's your style, right? For names, of course. Do you like unusual and interesting names, or do you prefer classic and popular names? So you can write which one would you be. Do you like saying this name out loud, because you're going to be saying this name forever? Do you want to observe a religion tradition with choosing this name? Maybe if your religion have a popular name that you want to repeat, that's one thing that you can put in your list. Yes, that's important for me. No, that's not important for me. Do you want to honor a family member or pay tribute to a cultural heritage? Also something you can write down, whether you are doing that or not. That can also narrow down the possibilities for you. Do you and your partner agree on that name? Because no one else is important, guys. Doesn't matter what your mother-in-law thinks, what your best friend thinks, is about you. You like the name, you're going to call that name a lot, and you love the name as well as your partner. Your partner also needs to agree with you on that choice. So if both of you like the name or can agree on a name, that's a very important decision to make. Will your child be able to introduce himself or herself with confidence with their name? Maybe that's not important for you, but think about your child. That's like a gift you're giving to your baby. And the last thing is, what is the name's meaning? Sometimes names have no meaning whatsoever, which is totally fine as well to choose. Maybe you want to choose a name that has a beautiful meaning, that represents something to you. So put in the list as well, and then you select names that you potentially like and your partner potentially like, and see if that name meet the criteria of these questions that you ask yourself. So that can narrow down your choices, because there are a million of choices and a lot of beautiful names to choose from. And after asking these 7 questions, you will be able to choose this beautiful gift that you will give to your child, which is your first gift, and it's the identity, is the name. We hope this is helpful. Share with your friends, like, subscribe to this channel, and receive all the news that we are coming up with. Share in the comments below if you already chose the baby name for your baby, how was your decision-making process, and if you have any tips to share with us as well. So thank you so much, and I will see you next time. Bye.